Zurich again. Let's talk about a simple concept that's sometimes a bit hard to understand, and it's called scope. Variables and everything in JavaScript has a scope. And scope means the container in which it was defined, and only within that same container it is accessible or changeable. So let's look at code to see what I mean. Basically, a scope exists between curly braces. So everything inside these curly braces I can access this string. I can say string.length and see what's the length. Of course, it's the right name. But outside of this block, curly braces, I get an error. Some string is not defined because this line is not within the block where the string was created. So you get to see a block like this, or curly braces like this, for instance, in an if statement. So I can say if true, which will always run this code, or if 6 or 4 is greater than 6, well, then it doesn't run this code. 4 is smaller than 6, it does run this code, but it's still a block. So this variable SomeString only exists within that block. Another reason you have a block is when it's a function. So when I would create function here, ishi. So now here, this is also a block. Well, now this function is not called, so let's call it. And it works in the same way. Well, so that's basically the simple part of a scope. A block is a scope, and everything that's defined within a block will is accessible within the block. But then there's one more complication, which is that not only the things that are in this block are accessible within the block, but also things that are created outside, so in the parent block. So let's put this function inside this block, and then put the call here as well. Now if I create another variable here, let's say another string, and I access that here, I can also get the length of the other string, because this function, or actually this block, is created within the yellow block. So the pink block is created within the yellow block. So within the pink block, you can access everything that exists or that is created inside the yellow block as well. And maybe this is a bit of an artificial situation with the block like this, but let's change it around a little bit, where we have inside this function we have the if statements. Let's see, if statement if true again does not do anything, will always run. If we now create some other string inside here, and we call our new function, otherwise nothing happens. We see here that because this variable was created inside this pink block, we cannot access it inside outside of that pink block. But we can access this one within this block. So you can access this variable because it was created inside the parent block. And if we would move this one inside here, then it works again because now this variable is accessed within the pink block where it's also created. Well, then there's one more thing, and it is, what's up with outside of any blocks? So outside of this yellow block, here I can also create a variable. And this variable is said to be in the global scope. It is created outside of any block, which means any scope can access it. So you can access it from inside here. You can say here fancy number at length. Does that work? Let's see. No, it's undefined. The number doesn't have a length. But we can say fancy number dot to string. Then we make a string, create a string from it, and then dot length. And then it has length too. So fancy number, it is in global scope. Global scope. So we can access it from any other scope in our program. And normally you actually want to avoid using or putting things in global scope, because now actually I can not only access this variable and look up its length, but I can also change it. Well, not really true, because I made it a const, but if it would be a let, then I can actually change it to something else. And if you now have code here that uses the fancy number, then it suddenly changed, so you expect it to be 42 maybe. And this can lead to bugs in your program, because one part of your program changes something that you use in another part, and then it's really hard to figure out what is going on. So we try to put things inside the scope and only use it from inside that scope. So in this case, if I would need to use this fancy number inside Fishy, instead of accessing it like this, I would have to put it as a parameter here. So let's say I have this number from outside. Let's remove everything else. Okay. Here we go, and then we say number from outside. And then we pass in a fancy number here. Then we see the fancy number still is not changed, although I tried to change it here. It is not changing the original. It's only changing the one that was passed in here. See here, it's still 42. Then we can change it, but we don't change this one.